Buju, Anin. We're presenting a retrospective exhibition of Minnesota artist Carl Gawboy. Carl is Bois Fort Anishinaabe and Finnish, and his art reflects the traditions of both cultures and his roots in Minnesota. We recorded Carl discussing six of his paintings in the exhibition. One of those recordings follows this introduction.
Well, from family stories and from the stories that I heard growing up, we're not talking about the myths here. We're just talking about what people did and how people harvested things and how they lived.
A UMD graduate with a master's degree from the University of Montana, Carl taught American Indian Studies and watercolor for 18 years at UMD and the College of St. Scholastica. A lifelong learner and teacher, Carl has become an accomplished historian in northeastern Minnesota. From the time he was a UMD student in the early 1960s, Carl Gawboy has dedicated his life to visualizing stories through art and teaching others. His art is held by private collectors, educational institutions, tribal organizations, nonprofit and commercial entities, museums, the Superior Public Library, and Voyageurs National Park. Carl is a Minnesota treasure, and we are honored to showcase Carl and his contributions through this retrospective. As you listen to each recording, you will not only experience Carl at his best in storytelling, but you will also learn details of an event in Carl's family, Anishinaabe cultural traditions, and Minnesota history. We know you will enjoy these recordings as much as we do, and we look forward to sharing with you the seminal exhibition of the art of Carl Gawboy at the Tweed Museum of Art.
The last roundup on Lac la Croix. All through the 20th century, the Indians, the Ojibwes at Lac la Croix had ponies, and they would use the ponies to skid logs out of the woods with firewood and pulpwood. And they would put the horses during the summertime on an island. And this island had a campground on it. And when I worked for the Forest Service, one of our jobs was to clean that campsite. And as I went on this island for the first time and I looked around, I saw horse droppings everywhere. And so the ranger that was with us explained that the Indians put the horses there on the island. They stranded them there on the island for the summer, and then the winter brought them to the village where they were used for skidding chores. And in the 1960s, there was a fellow at Net Lake named Fred Isham who'd heard that the Lac la Croix Indians had mechanized their logging operations and were using snowmobiles and tractors. And so they were going to abandon their horses on this island. And when he heard that, he thought that there had to be a way to save the horses. So he arranged to have the horses rounded up. So in the middle of winter, with the local Indians there driving their snowmobiles, they rounded up the ponies into corrals, then loaded them on trucks, on stock trucks, and drove them across the ice to the nearest highway, then drove them to a ranch in northern Minnesota, where they were put up and saved, and they were kind of protected from being interbreeding with other horses because it was suspected that they were a very old breed. They thought that they might have been old Spanish Mustangs from the northern plains that might have been sold to the Ojibwe by the Sioux in the late 19th century when they had to give up their horse herds. Well, that was before DNA testing. And now that DNA testing around, they've tested out these horses and found out, yes, indeed, they were old Northern Plains horses. Their markings are paint markings, so which suggests that they're old Indian ponies. And just recently, there were some newspaper articles about them and about this unique breed. And there are people who own some of the stock now and drive around visiting schools and things, introducing children to this very old breed.